We all know that researchers have been fascinated with space, but there is something else that has piqued their interest. It's unveiling the curiosity as to what is hiding beneath the ice of Antarctica. Its permafrost is swiftly thawing, revealing mysteries concealed beneath it for many years. We can't deny that anything could be buried beneath the sparkling snow-covered crown of a glacier. It's not a surprise, then, that scientists are curious about the secrets hidden beneath Antarctica's blanket of ice. Even I can't help but wonder if the depths of Antarctica have been hiding relics of old civilizations or strange creatures, or if they hide illnesses or bacteria. Isn't that intriguing? Greenland was the first place that tried to uncover the secrets at the end of 2019. After that, a group of Japanese and Norwegian researchers found out that the world's second largest ice sheet conceals an underground river with a length of about 1.6 thousand kilometers, or about 1,000 miles. How did they discover such a location? Well, according to them, special radars were used to map the location of the under-ice rocks. Sections of the flat bottom were found at depths ranging from 300 to 500 meters, which equals 984 to 1640 feet below sea level, and in some cases even below 3 kilometers or 1.9 miles. Scientists created a computer model of the under-ice terrain using the data they have gathered. If it really is a river, that means that the source is the island's center and its waters flow into the sea from under the Petermann Fjord on the northern coast. The mysterious body of water was dubbed the Dark River by experts. This is due to the fact that the majority of it is inaccessible to sunlight. And if that river does exist, I'm curious as to whether life may exist therein. We'll leave the answer to this question to the scientists in the coming years. For now, let's talk about Antarctica's Lake Vostok. Lake Vostok remains the most studied body of water in Antarctica, and its size is pretty amazing. Lake Vostok has a surface size of 15,700 square kilometers, or 6,061 square miles, with a depth of 1,200 meters, or almost 4,000 feet. Because of the energy from the rocky bottom of Lake Vostok and the pressure of the ice layers, this ghost lake does not solidify to the bottom. The air temperature above the lake's surface can drop to minus 89 degrees Celsius, or negative 128 degrees Fahrenheit. The average water temperature, on the other hand, is minus 3 degrees Celsius, or 27 degrees Fahrenheit. However, due to the potential hydrothermal spring activity, it should be significantly warmer at further depths, approximately 10 degrees Celsius or 50 degrees Fahrenheit. This depth is not illuminated by sunlight, and the pressure can reach 400 bar, while the amount of organic carbon in the atmosphere is relatively low. However, the most intriguing fact about this lake is the presence of a 50-fold increase in oxygen compared to a regular body of water. Which leads us to the question, does life exist here? To answer this question, scientists had to put in a lot of effort to get to the lake. They had to drill through nearly 4 kilometers, or about 2.5 miles of ice. Unfortunately, their ice drilling equipment failed twice in the process, and the researcher had no choice but to put the project on hold for 7 years. They had to look for a more modern and safe drilling method. As a result, the project began in 1989 and took 24 years to finish. However, the wait was worthwhile when researchers discovered life in the lake. The DNA of the bacteria Hydrogenophilus thermoluteolus, discovered in ice samples in 2004, was the life that existed in the lake. It was really surprising to find this bacteria in the lake, given the fact that this organism prefers living in spaces where the temperature ranges from 50 to 52 degrees Celsius, or 122 to 125 degrees Fahrenheit. So what could be the reason it was found in an ice lake? Well, scientists assume that the bacteria came from the deep faults near the lake, where it's warm, has a little oxygen, and a lot of carbon dioxide. It may just be that the seismic activity around Lake Vostok was what pushed this bacteria from the faults into the water's upper layers. a big discovery in Lake Vostok has stunned the science world once again. American researchers discovered evidence of the genetic material of bacteria that are commonly found with marine mollusks, crustaceans, and even fish in Lake Vostok. They couldn't help but wonder if such a lake could actually be hiding such a diverse environment. However, some argue that the strange findings in the lake are simply relics of the lake's old past. Those were the days when it was overflowing with all kinds of life. Perhaps the discoveries are simply due to the contamination from the drilling procedure when scientists approached the lake. This is also a scientific question that has yet to be answered. Russian scientists collected the most recent set of discoveries from the lake in January 2015. After cleaning the samples they found, Russian scientists discovered 49 DNA samples from various bacteria species, but just two of them piqued their interest. One type of DNA found was identical to the bacterium Janthinobacterium sp, while the other belonged to an undiscovered species and matched less than 86% of its DNA with known living creatures on our planet. Scientists discovered a third suspected inhabitant of Lake Vostok in 2018, and this is from the Lactobacillus species. So far, there are more questions than answers about this bacterium. Isn't it strange that this bacterium feeds on organic matter that is nearly non-existent in the frozen lake it was discovered? Does this imply that the bacteria arose at depths of the ocean? The dispute regarding the lake's discovery is still ongoing. However, one thing is evident from these discoveries. The water in the lake is not as pure as it seems it is. Rather, it could be concealing a lot of nature's wonders. Only when the drilling equipment reaches the lake's bottom, where the water is warmer and richer in mineral nutrients, will a breakthrough in discovery happen. This implies you'll have to wait until clean drilling technology is developed. This is the only way to get completely clean water samples, free of contaminants. Lake Vostok is similar to Pandora's box in that we have no idea what we're going to find. We have no idea if there are any dangerous creatures lurking beneath the ice in the lake. History tells us that the moment ice melted, dangerous bacteria and viruses emerged. A 12-year-old kid, for example, died of anthrax in a remote region of the Russian tundra on the Yamal Peninsula in 2016. Another 24 patients were diagnosed with the same case. But the effect isn't only on humans. Animals were harmed as well. It was surprising that an illness had not been detected in the area since 1941, killed almost 2,000 deer. The spread of this deadly disease could be attributed to an animal carcass that had been buried in frozen soil for many years. When the ground was warmed by hot air, microorganisms that had been inactive for almost 75 years awakened. Fortunately, the outbreak was rapidly contained, but experts were still concerned. Every year, the Earth's temperature rises, exposing ice layers. In 2005, a team of American researchers recreated the 1918 Spanish flu virus, which killed between 50 and 100 million people. They got the viral genes in the tissues of a woman who died in Alaska's tundra. Researchers have tested the virus on animals. Then the test revealed that the recreated virus traveled throughout the body at incredible speeds, resulting in death. It was even possible to revive a previously unknown microbe from permafrost, where it had been dormant for 32,000 years in a frozen pond in Alaska. During the Pleistocene, the bacteria Cranobacterium pleistocinium existed. Woolly mammoths may have been roaming around the region during that period. In 2007, scientists discovered 8 million-year-old bacteria that had been dormant for 2 years. It was discovered deep beneath a glacier in Antarctica's Beacon Valley and Mullins Valley. Scientists were able to determine the half-life of a genome in ice to be 1.1 million years as a result of this research. In early 2020, a group of international virologists disclosed their most recent findings. They examined ice samples ranging in age from 15,000 to 500,000 years old from China's Tibetan Plateau. They detected DNA remnants from 33 virus groups in the ice samples, including 28 previously undiscovered virus types. The fact that these bacteria were so distinct is noteworthy, to say the least. Scientists assume that the differences between these bacteria are related to different climate periods. They are positive that they did not make any errors in their research. Only ice that has been thoroughly cleaned of all impurities are studied by urologists. The discovery was made to benefit the scientific community. With all of this evidence, we may safely conclude that the Earth's ice sheet conceal a rich ecosystem. It's not surprising either. They could be subglacial rivers, lakes, unusual ecosystems, dangerous viruses, and bacteria. In an area of more than 50,000 square kilometers, or almost 20,000 square miles. Although it would be amazing to uncover centuries-old secrets, many say that we should not attempt to uncover what nature has carefully concealed beneath the ice. Let us simply wait for the sun to melt the ice and see what is beneath its surface. What do you think about this? Tell us in the comments. Don't forget to like this video and subscribe to the channel. Please click the bell icon so you'll be notified when new videos are posted. And as always, thanks for watching.